Hi, welcome back. So we're going to go ahead and talk about the double angle formulas. And as I mentioned in the introduction video, the double angle formulas are a subset of, well, they're actually a consequence of the angle sum identities. If, in other words, if you think about what would happen with the angle sum identities, if you worked with sine alpha plus alpha, you'd be working with sine 2 alpha and you'd get 2 sine alpha cosine alpha. Now, so the double angle formula for sine is pretty straightforward. The double angle formula for cosine looks a little more intimidating because there's 3 different forms. So this is the primary form. In other words, cosine 2 alpha is equal to cosine squared minus sine squared. That one always works. These other two also work. And they come from combining this guy with the fact that sine squared alpha plus cosine squared alpha equals 1. So in other words, if you combine the basic double angle formula for cosine with the Pythagorean identity, you get these two alternate forms. And which one you use really depends on the problem you're solving and how... which one's going to be most convenient? So we're going to start by just playing some games here. So let's start with this. Let's start with if sine theta equals 3/5 and theta is in the second quadrant, find the exact value for sine 2 theta. Now, the first thing to do is be careful and realize this does not say theta equals 3/5. This says sine theta equals 3/5. And while we're at it, we're going to go ahead and find the exact value of cosine 2 theta. So what are we doing? Well, we're actually going to apply our double angle formula. In order to apply our double angle formula, we need both sine and cosine. So we'll remember that if sine theta equals 3/5, we can find cosine theta a couple of different ways. I'm going to today go ahead and just use the Pythagorean identity. So the Pythagorean identity says that the sine squared of theta plus the cosine squared of theta equals 1, which means that 3/5 squared plus cosine theta squared equals 1, which means that cosine theta squared is equal to 1 minus 9/25, which is 16/25. So cosine theta is positive or negative 4/5, right? Which one do we want? Well, we're in the second quadrant, so we want the negative cosine. Okay, and now we're ready to apply the double angle formulas. So sine 2 theta equals 2 sine theta times cosine theta, which means that this is 2 times 3/5 times negative 4/5, which is negative 24/5. 20/5, excuse me. Okay? And cosine 2 theta, and you can take your preference. I think I'm going to use this form. So I was given sine. So just to make sure I don't carry forward any mistakes I might have made, I'm going to use this guy because sine was given to me. So cosine 2 theta is 1 minus 2 sine squared theta, which is going to be 1 minus 2 times 3/5 squared, which is 1 minus 1 minus 18/25, which is just 7/25. So cosine 2 theta is equal to 7/25. Sine 2 theta is equal to -24/25. Now, what if you were asked for tangent 2 theta? Well, tangent 2 theta is equal to sine 2 theta divided by cosine 2 theta, which in this case would be -24/25 divided by 7/25, or we can invert that bottom fraction and multiply, and we get -24/7. Okay, that's not so bad. Let's use this identity to simplify a trigonometric, well, to prove an identity. So we've got an equation, but excuse me, we've got an equation here that somebody tells me is true, and I'm asked to prove it or disprove it. So we're going to prove that the secant of 2 theta is equal to secant squared theta over 2 minus secant squared theta. All right, what's the first thing I'm going to do? Well, so first, how am I going to approach this? I always find it easier to go from complicated to simple. So I'm actually going to start with the right-hand side and move towards the left-hand side. So I'm going to start with this. Secant squared theta divided by 2 minus secant squared theta. First thing I'm going to do is turn everything into sines and cosines. In this case, all I have is secants, so I'm going to turn it into cosines. So I've got 1 over cosine squared theta divided by 2 minus 1 over cosine squared theta. All right, so I want to clear those fractions. This is a complex fraction. I'm going to multiply through by cosine squared theta over cosine squared theta. In other words, I'm multiplying by 1. What that does for me is it cancels this, and then when I multiply through on the bottom, what I end up with is 1 over 2 cosine squared theta minus 1. Oh, hey, I think I recognize that denominator. I do. 2 cosine squared minus 1 is another word for cosine 2 theta. So this is 1 over cosine 2 theta, which is secant 2 theta. And we're done. We have proven the identity. Okay, so that's one use. I'm going to come back in the next video and we're going to solve a couple problems. We're going to solve an equation and we're going to solve a word problem. All right, I'll be right back.